عظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم باستشهاد الإمام الحسين عليه السلام. السلام عليك يا مولاي يا أبا عبد الله. السلام عليك يا مولاي يا ابن رسول الله. Umar ibn Sa'ad calls 10 horse riders to trample the bodies of the masters of Karbala. They come to the body of Ali Akbar, and the tribe of Ali Akbar stands up. They say, "We claim the body of Ali Akbar." They don't trample the body of Ali Akbar. They came to the body of Qasim ibn al-Hasan. The tribe of Qasim stood up. They claimed the body of Qasim ibn al-Hasan. They saw a body without any hands laying on the sands of Karbala next to the river. Umar cried, "Trample the body of Aba al-Fadl al-Abbas." Allah. The tribe of Banu Kilab stood up. They said, "Abbas is of us. Do not trample the body of Abbas." They didn't trample the body of Abbas. There was only one body left laying on the sands of Karbala. It was a body without a head. It was a body that had arrows laying in its chest. It was a body that was even stripped of its clothes. Hussein, Mawla Hussein, Allah. He said, "Who is this body for?" They told him, "That is the body of Hussein." Umar ibn Sa'ad cried with the loudest of his voices. He said, "Ya khayl Allah, irkabi wa dusi ala sadr al-Hussein." He said, "O horses of Allah, trample upon the body of Hussein." The horses come towards the body of Imam al-Hussein, and they plunge their hooves deep into the chest of Abu Abdullah. Ya Hussein. It said that Zainab was in the tents. She turns to Imam al-Sajjad and she tells him, "Oh Sajjad, I hear something cracking, I hear something breaking. What's breaking, ya Sajjad?" Allah, Allah, Allah. He lifted the tents and they saw the body of Hussein being thrown left to the right, to the left side, to the right side. Allah, la ilaha illallah. One man comes to the body of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. He sees that there is a ring on the finger of Hussein. He sees there is a ring on the body of Abu Abdullah. He looks at the ring of Hussein. He says, "I want the ring." He takes out his blade and he cuts the finger of Abu Abdullah. (Laughs) They would burn the tents of Zainab. They burn the tents of Sukaina. Sukaina comes out of the tents with her abba on fire, screaming, Wa Muhammada, Wa Aliya, Al-Zalima, Al-Zalima. She sees a sheikh, she comes up to him, she tells him, Ya sheikh, hal qara'ta al-Qur'an? She tells him, Ya sheikh, have you read the Qur'an? He says, yes, I've read it. She tells him, have you remembered the verse which said, فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ? The orphan shouldn't be hurt. He said, yes, I've read that verse. She tells him, Ya Shaykh, Ana yateemat Aba Abdullah. Allah. She tells him, Ya Shaykh, I am the orphan of Aba Abdullah. Night falls upon Karbala. Zainab, the one whose shadow wasn't seen, is now in the hands of Bani Umayyah. In Medina, Ali would walk in front of Zainab, Abbas to her left, Hassan to her right, Hussein behind her. Yes. The shadow of Zainab wasn't seen. I tell him, Ya Sahib al-Zaman. One day her shadow isn't seen. Another day her cheeks are smacked by the hands of shame. May Allah give you patience. May Allah give you all patience. Forgive me, Ya Sahib al-Zaman. Forgive me. Zainab is sitting in the tents. She sees that there's a shadow coming closer to the tents. She tells him, oh person, I don't know who you are, but don't harm me. I am the daughter of Ali. I am the queen of Bani Hashim. I am the queen. I am the queen of Bani Hashim. My father is Ali. My dad is Ali. Laila. The shadow ignores the request of Zainab, and it continues to come towards the tents of Zainab. She tells him, oh shadow, I swear upon you once again by my father Ali, don't harm me. He tells her, oh Zainab, don't swear upon me by Ali. I am Ali. I am Ali. I am Ali. You know what she tells him? She tells him, Father, it's too late. Hussein's neck has been cut. Father, it's too late. Severed, severed. Father, it's too late. The neck of Ali Asghar has been severed. The mother of Ali Al-Asghar would go on to the field, tripping over the masters of Karbala. She comes to a six-month-year-old baby. She tells him, Ali, drink from my chest. Ali, drink from my chest. Ali Asghar. Ali Asghar. One man comes to the tents of Zainab alayhi salam, and he comes to Sukaina and he rips the earrings from the ears of Sukaina alayhi salam. She tells him, why would you do this? You know what he said? He said, if I don't do it, somebody else will. Allahu Akbar. That's why. Because if I don't do it, somebody else will do it. This is the reason. Zainab alayhi salam. She looks left, there is no Abbas. She looks right, there is no Hussein. They tell her, oh Zainab, where are your men today? Zainab, where are your protectors today? Zainab, where is Ali today? Zainab, where is Abbas? It is said in the middle of the night, she would go also onto the sands of Karbala. You know which body she was looking for? She was looking for the hands that brought her from Medina. She was looking for the hands that protected her, the hands of Abbas. She comes to a body without any hands. She takes the hands and she wants to reattach and reassemble it to the body. She tells him, Abbas, wake up. Abbas, wake up. Abbas, they have burnt our tents. Wake up, wake up, Abbas. Abbas, they ripped the earrings from Sukaina Abbas. Allah. Abbas, come and see what they did to the body of your brother Hussein. Mawlai, Mawlai, Abu Abdullah. Allah. Wallahi, there's so much masa'ib to remember today. Sham-e-Ghareeban was the true pain that was put into the hearts of Al Muhammad. To think of Zainab as a ghareeba, to think of Zainab as a asira, was never, never expected by Al Muhammad. With their foresight, with their wisdom, they never expected Zainab alayhi salam to be treated in the way that she was. No. Some say that the hijab of Zainab was ripped off of her head. Allah. Others say, no, the hands of foreigners were smacking the cheeks of Zainab alayhi salam. Others say that Sukaina alayhi salam, not only were her earrings ripped, but she has no one to protect her. This is a musibah, brothers and sisters. She's looking around for someone to protect her, for someone to take her to the body of Abu Abdullah, until she came to that man. You know what she told him? She told him, oh man, can you take me to Najaf? Can you take me to Ali alayhi salam? If Hussein is dead, then Ali ibn Abi Talib can hear my mushtaka, mushtaka, mushtaka. Ali can hear my complaints, my complaints, my complaints. Allah. It is said that Zainab alayhi salam was being taken to Sham on these nights. While they're being taken, leaving Karbala for the last time, she stops the caravan and she said, let me go and farewell Hussein one last time, one last time, one last time. Sham, Sham. She came down From the camel she said, Ya Zain al-Abidin, let me go and farewell Hussein one last time, Hussein. He told her, Ammati Zainab, irhami dha'fa badani. On Zainab, have mercy on the weakness of my body. On Zainab, irhami qillata hilati. On Zainab, farewell me, or have mercy on me. I have no more strength, O Zainab. He's telling her, I can't handle seeing you above the body of Aba Abdullah. That image was a hurtful image to Imam al-Sajjad. She told him, what should I do, Ya Ibn Rasulillah? He told her, Waddi' ya khaki min ala dhahr al-naqaya. On Zainab, mount the camel and farewell Hussein. Zainab mounts the camel, what does she do? She says, As-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. As-salamu alayka ya akhi ya Hussein, ya Hussein, ya Hussein. Not only this, it is said that she would see an old man above the body of Imam al-Hussein. An old man with ripped clothing, with disheveled hair, with no slippers on his feet. She saw this older man with white hair and a white beard on the body of Aba Abdullah alayhi salam. She told him, oh man, his finger is cut, his head is cut, his body is trampled, there is no clothes on his body. What else could you possibly take from the body of Hussein? He told her, oh Zainab, didn't you recognize me? I am Rasulullah. Allah. Ana jadduki Muhammad. I'm your grandfather. Yes?
Grandfather.
أنا جدك محمد. He was looking at the wounds of Aba Abdullah. Imagine this image, I beg you. He's looking at the body of Aba Abdullah. He's saying, صلى عليك ملك السماء قتلوك وما عرفوا من جدك ومن أبوك. May Allah and the angels of Allah pray upon you. They killed you and they didn't know who your father was and who your grandfather was. As-salamu ala al-Husayn.
All together with one voice to Sham, to Karbala, to the Zuwar, with the Zuwar, buzz alongside them, buzz alongside them.
As-salamu ala al-Husayn.
Where is the Husayni?
As-salamu ala al-Husayn wa ala Ali ibn al-Husayn.
Awlad
wa ala awladin.
أصحاب أصحاب
وعلى أصحاب الحسين اللهم بلغ مولانا الإمام المهدي منا تحية وسلاما اللهم اجعلنا من خدام الحسين اللهم اجعلنا من زوار أبا عبد الله ومن خدام الحسين Oh Allah, let us be from those who fight alongside صاحب الزمان to revenge Al-Muhammad.